During this demonstration, we will introduce you to the NASA Earth Observing System Data and Information System, or EOSDIS, Worldview Imagery Mapping and Visualization application. This tool provides the capability to interactively browse over 900 global, full-resolution satellite imagery layers. Many of these layers are updated daily and are available within 3 hours of observation. Also available are geostationary imagery layers, which are provided in 10-minute increments for the last 30 days. These full-disk hemispheric views allow for almost real-time viewing of changes occurring around most of the world, essentially showing the entire Earth as it looks right now. Worldview's easy-to-use map interface lets you interactively explore NASA Earth Science imagery to see hurricanes forming, wildfires spreading, icebergs drifting, and city lights illuminating. Let's get started. First, we'll go to Worldview by typing in worldview.earthdata.nasa.gov into the browser, like I've already done. When Worldview first starts, you will see a window welcoming you to Worldview. This window contains an array of tour stories where you can learn about how to use Worldview to explore events happening around the world, such as hurricanes, dust storms, bushfires, and more. Let's click on the first tour, the bushfires in Australia, from September 2019 to January 2020. As we go through the steps, you can see that the tour is showing different satellite data imagery layers to view the fires and ways in which you can use Worldview's features to investigate these events. Click on the check or tick mark on the last step and you'll reach the end of the tour. Here you will find additional links to NASA feature stories about the Australian fires. Let's click on the exit tutorial and the Worldview logo to reset the map to its defaults. Worldview is much like other interactive maps you may have encountered before. You can zoom in and out of the map using the plus and minus buttons on the right side of the map, or the mouse scroll wheel. You can also click and hold the mouse button down to pan the map. Worldview gives you the ability to display a large range of global Earth science satellite imagery, with some dating back to February 2000. With observations from the Moderate Resolution Imaging Spectral Radiometer, or MODIS instrument, aboard NASA's Terra satellite. Change the date for your imagery by using the timeline, located in the lower left corner. Either type in a different date, or use the up and down arrows above the year, month, and day fields, or the back and forward arrows. You can also use the pick on the timeline to move to another date. Say you found something interesting and want to show it to your colleagues. You can take a snapshot of the image and share it with them. Click on the camera icon in the upper right corner. Adjust the corners of the box to select the area of interest. You can select your desired output resolution and output file format. Click on download and you can save your output image to your computer. To change the map projection, click on the globe icon in the upper right corner of your screen. Here you will notice that in addition to imagery being available in the geographic projection, some of Worldview's satellite imagery layers are also available in polar stereographic projections for the Arctic and Antarctic. If you click on the Arctic projection, you can see a top-down view of the North Pole, and by clicking on the Antarctic projection, you'll see a black hole in the center of the imagery. This is because it's wintertime there and there isn't enough reflected sunlight to provide an image. It's like trying to take a photograph in the dark. Let's go back to the geographic projection and show you where to find those 900 plus layers. In the layer panel on the left, click on the orange Add Layers button at the bottom of the panel. Next, you will see a window showing different categories of scientific measurements sorted by hazards and disasters, science disciplines, and featured. You can either enter your own keyword into the search bar or browse through the categories. The featured tab shows off the most widely used layers and the newest layer additions. Let's click on the featured layers tab and select Earth at Night. Now check the box next to nighttime imagery, day-night, enhanced near constant contrast to see what the world looks like at night. Okay, now let's go back to the layer panel to explore another key feature of Worldview, the Events tab. This tab shows a recent list of some of the natural events happening around the world right now. This information has been curated by NASA's Earth Observatory Natural Event Tracker, or EONET for short. Let's change to the Antarctic projection and select Iceberg D28 in the event listings. This massive iceberg calved from the Amory Ice Shelf in late September 2019. Our first step will be to look back to the first date in the list, September 27th, 2019. Let's click on the date. The map imagery will update and you can see the iceberg separating from the ice shelf. We can track the iceberg's movement by creating an animation using the animation tool. Now let's click on the video camera icon in the timeline, located in the lower left. Worldview will set the time period automatically to 10 days. We are going to change the frames per second to 10 by dragging the center button all the way to the right. Now we'll click play to see the iceberg move in those 10 days. You can also click on the loop video button next to the play button to repeat the animation. Now let's export this to an animated GIF. Click on the Create Animated GIF button on the right side of the animation panel. Adjust the box like you did for the image snapshot and then click Create GIF. Worldview will show that it's requesting imagery. Wait for the GIF results window to appear and then click on Download to download the animated GIF. Next, we are going to close the GIF window by clicking outside of the window or the X in the upper right corner. Click back on the Layers tab and then select the Start Comparison button next to Add Layers. The comparison tool allows you to compare the same imagery from different dates, different imagery for the same date, or whatever combination you would like. Once you click on Start Comparison, you'll see the screen split. We are now in the swipe comparison mode. You will notice that on the left is the A side, and on the right is the B side. Move the center line to the left and right to compare the imagery from the date on the left and the imagery from the date on the right side. There are two other comparison modes, Opacity and Spy. Click on Opacity near the orange Add Layers button. This mode fades the imagery between A and B. Click on Spy to see a spyglass superimpose on the imagery. The large map is the A imagery, the spyglass is the B imagery. If you select the B tab in the layer panel, the imagery will switch. Click on Exit Comparison next to the Add Layers button to exit out of the comparison tool. Let's see how big this iceberg is. Click on the ruler icon on the lower right side of the screen, next to the scale bar. The measurement tool allows you to measure distance and area. Let's try measuring the area of the D28 iceberg. Click on Measure Area. Click to add the first point of the corner of the iceberg. Continue to trace around the perimeter of the iceberg, clicking to add another point each time. Double-click to end the area polygon and to see the estimated size of the iceberg. Click back on the ruler icon and then Remove Measurements to remove the measurements on the map. In addition to being able to share a snapshot of the imagery and an animated GIF with your colleagues, you might just want to share a Worldview link to your imagery so that they can interact with the imagery themselves. Click on the Share Link icon in the upper right corner. It will populate a URL that will save all of your presets in the map. You can also click on Shorten Link to provide a shorter, more readable, and shareable link. Click on Copy next to the URL and open a new tab. Paste the URL there to view the same map you are looking at. For many of the layers in Worldview, you can also download the underlying data. So let's turn on the Modus Terra sea ice layer by clicking on the eye icon next to the layer name. It will show sea ice in pink. Click on the Data tab in the layer panel. Let's zoom out a little bit to see what there is to download. You'll see lines with plus signs in the center. Let's say we are interested in data for this area. So we click on the plus sign to add this data. Your view will update to show the granule that covers the area you are interested in. Click on Download Data in the Layer panel. The Download Links panel will open to show the URLs where you can download the HDF file. Now that we've gone over the general features and functionality of Worldview, I hope that you will go and start exploring for yourselves
at worldview.earthdata.nasa.gov. Thank you.